Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky back in the laboratory, this time with a clinic on gold base coating. All right, this is going to be the first of a maybe two, three, or four video series clinics. I want to walk you through it. We've got everything ready to go here now. As always, with all of our videos on painting, we always stress safety and making sure that you protect your health. So we are going to be shooting urethane, house of color urethane, all right? So you want to protect your hands, little latex gloves, long sleeves, or fairly long sleeves. These shrunk. But you want to protect your skin, you want to protect your eyes, and most importantly, you want to protect your lungs, all right? So you have to wear your respirator. I'm going to wear the respirator. I'm not going to be talking through the video. I'll do whatever talking I need to do in post-production. And I have the door open, a bunch of ventilators blowing the air out, and all of that good stuff. Now, in this little bottle right here, we have water, okay? And what I normally will do is I will mist water. Let me remove the model parts here, the hood and the trunk, which I have already set up. And of course, the body. I'll get the body out of the way as well. And a little bit of water is not going to hurt your airbrush. So, you know, you just basically mist a little bit of water throughout because that's going to help. It's an old trick. It's going to help keep the dust and particulates from the air, you know. I don't know, something about static electricity, blah, blah, blah. But I always do that. Old habits die hard. We are going to be shooting, since we're dealing with a base coat, and of course a metallic base coat, we are going to be using our Awada M2 airbrush, which is very good for this kind of work. And so we're going to get started. And remember, you know, there's going to be a few of these because we're doing gold first, and then we're going to do silver, okay, as base coats. Not on the same model, of course, but we're beginning with gold, and then we're going to move on to silver for the next vehicle. All right, so stay tuned in. This segment is brought to you by the rat in Lab-RAT-ory. Thank you. Ha 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 ha. All right, we're getting the spray pattern here, and making sure everything is flowing correctly. Getting the airbrush ready. This Awada airbrush always does a fantastic job with metallizer paints, which of course include silver and gold. We're beginning to spray the body in smooth, even strokes from side to side. It's very important that you don't bomb the thing with a lot of paint at first. You want to go slow, methodic. The thing about this airbrush, which is why you're seeing my finger on and off, going on and off, is that it's a single action airbrush. So in order to get the paint flowing, you have to press down on the trigger. It's not a system I like per se, but you get used to it. You get used to using different kinds of airbrushes. And now you also see the reason for wearing latex gloves. I wanted to have a little bit more control of how I turned the body. I didn't want to mount it. And also that when you're working with House of Color paints,
basically it dries very fast. So it dries to the touch and it's not a problem. But the latex gloves also prevent you from leaving fingerprints. So, you know, you put it down, you turn it around, making sure that all the panels are covered. Everything is, flowing smoothly so far. You don't necessarily see it in the video, but there are gold flakes floating all over the place, which is fine. A lot of them are getting trapped in that moisture from the spray, from the sprayed water. So, and you see the little bottle over on the right. I keep a little bottle of water like that. And, if things start flying around too badly, I spray a little bit more water. You also want to be careful because you don't want to get moisture in your paint as you're spraying it. So it's a delicate balance, but you'll get the hang of it once it gets going. Again, when I paint my bodies, I like to get the base color on it. On everything, underneath the fender wells, everything, underneath the headliner, the whole works. I mean, I'm painting the entire thing gold, and applying enough paint slowly so that I get full coverage eventually and thoroughly. So, and you begin to see the color taking there, but you also see a little bit of fading here and there, which basically lets you know that some of that primer, the gray, is still showing through. So you'll see me going around and around and around. I change directions every once in a while, just, again, to make sure, in particular with the panel, with the door seams, you want to get paint in there because you don't want to find out later that it looks light or you still see some of that gray. So, sometimes we put the model down and just, don't touch it and just spray paint. Now, here's something that real car painters often discuss, and it's a problem when you're spraying gold or silver. You get what is called tiger striping if you don't open up your brush enough. When you're working with scale models, it's not an issue, but in real cars, it is an issue because you want to make sure that you spray your pattern with a large enough fan pattern and then that you overlap that pattern so that you don't end up with these streaks. You see them on the top. Now, of course, you don't because I've been applying more paint. But that's usually the danger. But as I said, nothing to worry about with scale models because, it's just a smaller scale and paint is bound. If you apply enough paint, you're bound to get full coverage. So that's not a big deal. So you see there, even the headliner gets the paint. I just love this process, there's nothing more soothing than painting a scale model and then just watching that paint go on there. What I love about House of Color, of course, is that the paint really dries very quickly and it rises to the challenge and you're good to go. I mean, I paint... bodies in a couple of hours I can paint a body using House of Color. Not true with other paint systems. Createx and Auto Air, you have to dry them. House of Color, great colors, great coverage, just a wonderful paint. The only thing, of course, is that, and I remind you, everybody again, you must wear your respirator. You have to work with a respirator if you're working with this paint. There are no excuses. There's no reasons. You don't wear your respirator. You don't work with the paint. All right, my friends. Stay tuned in for part two. And let me know. I hope you're enjoying this one. And we'll be back. All right, my friends. Bye-bye.